The court has so fundamentally altered its own duties and so completely rejected the limits placed on it by the Constitution's checks and balances and enumerations of powers that the justices are in an endless search for extra constitutional justifications and interventions to explain their activism. The court that was given life by the Constitution cannot legitimately operate outside of it. Its only rightful and lawful authority exists solely within the Constitution's confines. James Madison put it this way: "I entirely concur in the propriety of resorting to the sense in which the Constitution was accepted and ratified by the nation. In that sense alone, it is the legitimate Constitution. And if that is not the guide in expounding it, there may be no security." Now, reality informs us that human beings are imperfect, including the mere 9 individuals who serve on the Supreme Court. The fact that they hold law degrees from prestigious law schools, wear black robes, and are each referred to as Your Honor, does not change the fallibility of their nature. Nor does the fact that from time to time the court issues rulings with which much of society agrees, or which might be considered just or even honorable. Even monarchs have been occasionally benevolent and wise. But this does not change the essential character of authoritarianism and the general mindset of those who would rule over citizens as subjects. Indeed, history belies the notion of an enlightened judicial oligopoly, immune from republican traditions and values. Whatever one may think of the Marbury decision, it cannot be denied that today the Supreme Court's power is ubiquitous.
Thanks so much for watching this video. To watch our latest video, click here. And to make sure you don't miss any future videos, be sure to subscribe.